the last so-called new drug for tuberculosis was developed almost 40-50 years back. And since then, practically speaking, no new drug has come to the market, which is already being in use as per textbooks or as per standard guidelines. To say that we do not require new drugs, that's why we are continuing with this, is not correct. The problems which we are facing with the existing drugs and the management of tuberculosis is, the biggest problem is the prolonged duration of treatment. Patient has to take treatment at least for 6 months as per the current guidelines and the current drugs which are available in the market. And if you talk about the so-called drug resistance, that is MDR tuberculosis, the duration goes up to 18 months, 2 years or more than that.
And the problem which is, or the issue which has emerged recently, is about drug resistant tuberculosis. So the existing drugs are not effective. By effective, I mean even if some patients who are, say, affected by drug resistant form of tuberculosis, giving them complete treatment with these basic drugs will not help them.
We spoke to Dr. Rohit Sareen, who is the director of Lala Ramswarup Institute of Tuberculosis and Respiratory Diseases. According to him, there is definitely a need to look for newer modes of treatment and drugs against tuberculosis. Also, we need to carefully use and conserve the existing modes of treatment and drugs. Another thing that the new drugs against tuberculosis need to take care of is that they must be specifically active against tuberculosis, and they need to take care of the fact that tuberculosis as a disease can lie dormant for years. The Lala Ramswarup Institute of Tuberculosis and Respiratory Diseases has collaborated with CSIR to work for the same.
Yes, the work is being done and 5-6 molecules have been identified. Few of them are already in phase 3 and few are in phase 2 and some of them are in phase 1. I should not say very satisfactory work has been done. But yes, this challenge has been taken up and we can say we have achieved something, so that by say next 1 or 2 or 3 years we can expect 1, 2 or 3 molecules to be in the market for use. But the time will tell us. At present, we are only optimistic, but we don't know what will happen.
As we know that most of the patients are not able to take treatment or adhere to treatment for a period of 6 months. And there could be a variety of reasons for that. One is that some patients experience some adverse effects, or side effects of the drugs. So once they experience side effects, they do not wish to continue drugs. So that's one reason. Other reason is that with the treatment beginning, within say 1 month of treatment, the patient would be free of his symptoms. In most of the cases, 90-95% patients, the treatment would relieve his symptoms within a month. And then there is no motivation for the patient many times to continue treatment for the next 5 months. And that is one more important reason why the patients do not adhere to treatment. And this adherence problems. Also, there are issues with respect to the affordability.
Regarding the cost, the cost of the first line drug, so called, when the patient is sensitive to the drugs, in that case it is affordable. Not much, but yes, it is high because patient has to take for 6 months. And for poor patient it becomes too much. And when you talk about the free drugs being distributed by the government, you know, you must have heard about DOTS, D-O-T-S, that is directly without treatment short course. There this patient has to go to the center every alternate day. Idea is to increase the compliance because they take it regularly, they stop it. But the very fact patient has to go to the center every alternate day in the first 2 months, and then once a week for the next 4 months or 6 months, again asking for too much. It becomes inconvenient for the patient. And sometimes the patient, they drop out or they do not enroll in such programs is because of this fact. So in those cases, these patients are missing the free distribution of drugs. And when we talk about MDR, TB or XDR tuberculosis, there the cost is exorbitant. Most of the poor patients are not able to afford this. So to reduce the cost also, we need newer drugs.